First just kind of waiting. I just am not gonna sit around and like, it's not something that I try to talk about or think about every day, because it's like, it affects my life. Like, I don't really need to think about it. But then I think, like, what if my phone wasn't in front of my face and I was like one of these people that got their eyes taken out? Like, I could have been blind. That's such a fucked up thing to think about. And it's like, just for kneeling there doing nothing behind a group of white people that are all standing up, I'm just like, I don't know. It's a really sad thing to think about, and it's kind of scary because it's like, damn, now I have to like leave my house every day with just like the thought in my head that there's just people in this world that are just going to be okay with hurting me just because I'm black. I think it's like a normal thing that a lot of black people have to think about, which is really, really unfortunate. It's kind of just in our bodies.
Hey, come on, we got
like this unknown knowledge that, like, for some reason, we're just perceived as like a threat that kind of needs to be neutralized.
First turned out to the first night of protests, I was just there to observe. I hadn't even seen the video of George Floyd. I didn't have much of a reason to be there. But what I saw that night really, really changed me, and I feel like what I saw would radicalize a whole lot of people, because that night was unbelievable.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim.
Crazy time in the world, and then an even crazier time in America.